This is part two of adding and subtracting rational expressions that have different denominators. So here's the first problem. 5 over x plus 2 minus 2x over x squared minus 4. Our first step is to rewrite these so that each denominator is factored. So let's do that. I'm going to write 5 over, well, x plus 2, that's as far as you can go, right? And my hint is, we're probably going to have to multiply by something, so I'm going to leave some space here, okay, before I put the minus sign in the next fraction. So we've got 2x over, now let's factor x squared minus 4, that's x plus 2 times x minus 2, all right? So if you're in the first denominator and you look over, you see what you don't have, you're missing an x minus 2. So you're going to need to multiply the numerator and denominator of this first fraction by x minus 2. And that is the least common denominator, x plus 2 times x minus 2. So the second fraction doesn't need to be multiplied by anything. You already have the common denominator. All right, so next step. We need to multiply the numerators together in this first fraction. In other words, you want to simplify the numerator of the first fraction. And at the same time, what I'm going to do to save some time, instead of writing both denominators down twice, I know that I have a common denominator, so I'm going to simplify this numerator and do the minus 2x all in the same step, so I only have to write the denominator down once. Okay? So I'm going to distribute the 5, 5x minus 10. And now I have to subtract the next numerator. It's just a 2x, so it's a minus 2x. But keep in mind, if it was like a 2x plus 5, you'd have to distribute that minus sign. All right, so now we have to simplify the numerator. So that's 3x minus 10 over x plus 2. Times x minus 2. Now notice I left the denominator factored. Usually it's easier to leave the denominator factored because the next step after you simplify the numerator is to see if you can factor and cancel with anything in the denominator. But in this case, 3x minus 10 doesn't factor, so this is your final answer. All right, now if you want, you can multiply out the denominators at the end. If you prefer to write that as x squared minus 4, that's perfectly fine. All right, here's another problem. So we're going to start the same way. We're going to rewrite each fraction, but with the denominators factored. So we have 2x over, and you could use scratch paper to figure out how to factor x squared plus 5x plus 6. It's x plus 2 times x plus 3. I go over factoring extensively in other videos. And then we might need to multiply by something, so I'm going to leave a little space here just in case. Plus, now I'm going to do the second fraction, factored, and that's x plus 3, x minus 3, since it's a difference of two squares, and we might need to multiply that by something as well. All right, so we start looking in the first denominator, and it looks over to the other denominator and see if there are any factors it doesn't have. So it looks over here, it already has an x plus 3, but it does not have an x minus 3. So I'm going to have to multiply this one, this first fraction, by x minus 3 over x minus 3. And now it has all the factors. So this first denominator is the least common denominator. Okay, so in fact, you can go down to the next line, and you know that least common denominator is going to be x plus 2 times x plus 3. Times x minus 3. All right, now we have to make sure the second denominator has the same three factors, right? There's three factors, x plus 2, x plus 3, and x minus 3. And what's it missing? It's missing an x plus 2. So I need to multiply it by x plus 2. All right, now what's the next thing we do? We have to simplify each numerator. So there's a distributive property in both of these, right? So in the first one, I've got 2x times x minus 3. So that'll be 2x squared minus 6x. Well, this is nice. There's a plus sign, so that'll be simpler. We don't have to distribute any minus signs. And we have to do the 3 times x plus 2. So that'll be a 3x plus 6. Okay. And then we combine like terms here. So I have 2x squared minus 3x plus 6 all over x plus 2, x plus 3, x minus 3. All right, the last thing you would have to do is see if you can factor that 2x squared minus 3x plus 6. As it turns out, it can't be factored. Okay? So, one thing you might try is to see if any of these factors in the denominator are factors, and try it. So x plus 2 doesn't end up being a factor. X plus 3, that won't work, and neither does x minus 3. So in this case, you're done. Even if it did factor, if it didn't have one of these factors, nothing would cancel in the end. And you could see that this is just fine to leave it in factored form. Otherwise, it's a lot of work to multiply all three of these factors together. All right, here's the next problem. 7 over 3x minus 2 plus 6x over 2 minus 3x. This is a tricky one. If you look at the denominators, they don't look the same. And in fact, they are not the same, but they are opposites. Anytime you notice you've got a binomial with minus signs in it, and then you've just reversed the order of what's before and after the minus sign, they end up being opposites. I went over this in some other videos, but in other words, A minus B is the same thing as the opposite of B minus A. Okay? So in this case, 3x minus 2 is the same thing as negative 1 times 2x minus 3. So if that happens, that means if you just take the second denominator and multiply it by negative 1 over negative 1, you can write down this problem is already having a common denominator. So I would have plus 6x times negative 1 is negative 6x. But then what's 2x minus 3x times negative 1? Remember, this is multiplying, is the same thing as 3x minus 2. So that's how to write this with the same denominator. All right, so now that was the easy way to get a common denominator. So the denominator is just 3x minus 2, and in the numerator we have 7 minus 6x. Now if you didn't notice that, this would become a much more complicated problem. In other words, if you multiplied the first fraction by 2 minus 3x over 2 minus 3x, and the second fraction by 3x minus 2 over 3x minus 2, you'll still get the same answer as long as you reduce at the end, but it becomes much more complicated when you already have just opposites in the denominator. So let's have you try another one like that. So here's a problem. 7 over x minus 4 minus 3 over 4 minus x. So how can you deal with this problem? Try it on your own. Okay, hopefully you notice that x minus 4 is exactly the opposite of 4 minus x. So I just need to multiply one of the fractions by negative 1. Let's take the second fraction. If I want to multiply the top and bottom by negative 1, then I get 7 over x minus 4. Now what's going to happen? I'm going to have minus and negative 3. See what's going to happen here? I'm going to have minus and negative 3. That ends up being a plus positive 3. You could do that at the next step if you want to leave that as minus and negative 3 over, and I've made it so the denominators are exactly the same. Notice I don't also want to multiply the first fraction by negative 1 over negative 1, because now they'd still be opposites. So you want to make them the same. Now you have a common denominator, so we just write the denominator once and add the numerators. And this can't be reduced, so there's the answer. All right, I'm going to do lots more problems on the next videos, because there are a lot of different things to try when you're adding fractions that have unlike denominators.